This video is sponsored by Mech Arena. One hot summer day in 2011, Samantha Jenkins left her house to go to the local co-op with her friends. When she came back home, she immediately went into her room. Later, she told her mother she was feeling out of sorts, saying that she bought a can of pop at the store, but it's gone right through me. Sam's mother, Maria Morgan, gave her daughter some tea to help hydrate, but she could barely even hold the mug. When she tried to pick it up, it kept falling to the floor. Morgan went to grab her daughter a blanket, but froze when she heard a massive thud from her room. When she came back, Sam looked up and asked, "Is this what it's like to die?" before she was rushed to the hospital. Medical staff, after failing to bring her condition under control, had to pronounce Sam dead before they were able to determine what was wrong with her. Having lost her daughter in a matter of hours, Morgan was desperate for answers. But after finding hundreds of chewing gum wrappers in her daughter's bedroom, she found the smoking gum she was looking for. When Samantha arrived at the hospital, she began convulsing violently. This terrified her mother and doctors alike, since her seizing was keeping them from administering the medications she needed to survive. Doctors decided to put her into an induced coma to end her convulsions so they could finally administer medical aid. Doctors found that her convulsions were caused by a deficiency of calcium, magnesium, sodium, and potassium, but they had no clue what was depriving her body of salts and minerals. Sam was then placed on a ventilator, but when they took her off the machine, she had fallen into a coma herself. Morgan was told that, as far as they could see, that something had poisoned her. It was just about trying to fathom out what it was so they could possibly save her, but it was too late. In the end, pathologist Dr. Paul Griffiths announced that Sam passed away from cerebral hypoxia caused by convulsions and electrolyte depletion, which basically means that her electrolytes were so low that it gave her seizures, and her convulsions cut off oxygen supply to her brain, leading to her death. When doctors asked Morgan if there was anything that might have changed about her daughter's habits leading up to her death, she didn't have a clue. Sam's sister, Sophie, mentioned, however, that she had been chewing a lot of gum lately. Morgan and Sophie then searched Sam's bedroom and found hundreds of sugar-free gum wrappers. Every bag that she had, and every drawer in her bedroom, there were chewing gum wrappers, empty chewing gum boxes. Every handbag had receipts at the bottom of it where she would buy chewing gum, said Morgan of her findings. Not only was Morgan unaware of her daughter's gum habits, she likely wouldn't have thought anything of it if she did know. Not everyone has time for long gaming sessions, but that doesn't mean you can't have fast-paced, fun gameplay on the fly. That's why I'm so excited about today's sponsor, Mech Arena Robot Showdown. I don't have to spend 15 minutes running in circles waiting for fights, since Mech Arena maps are built to give you as many encounters as possible. I can get straight to the action, and barely have time to celebrate before another fight starts. And okay, sure, my reflexes aren't the best, but I'll have you know that even I can frag some noobs. There are even tons of events going on as we speak. Get your hands on a bunch of awesome weapons like the brand new disc launcher. October holds a ton of special Halloween events too, with Halloween skins like the Renegade or the Parasite to win. There's also a login reward program, so you get weekly free credits, crates, and skins just for logging in. Mech Arena Robot Showdown is entirely free to play on Android and iOS. Click our link in the description or scan this QR code to get one Desert Digital skin, 200 A coins, and 10,000 credits to help you get a leg up over the competition. Oh, and if you're quick, you can add me on your friends list to play a few matches together. All right, punk. Mech my day. Doctors certainly were concerned when they found balls of chewing gum lodged inside Sam's stomach. Dr. Griffith said, "It was unusual. There was about 4 to 5 lumps of it." But he also noted that there is a potential for this much chewing gum to cause this problem, but it's not a hard fact. Did gum actually cause the convulsions that tragically took Sam's life? Or is there something else going on here? Sam's convulsions kept her from breathing properly, which denied her brain the oxygen it needed, all because of an electrolyte imbalance. But what could have drained her of electrolytes? And how could they cause seizures? Your nervous system, in order to work properly, needs to maintain electrical excitability. Neurons form your entire nervous system, and they're basically tiny individual links in very long electrochemical wires that snake around your body. Electrolytes are minerals and salts that conduct electricity when they are combined with water. Your body balances electrolytes through osmosis, which is the process of a substance equalizing its concentration across a liquid. If you have too much, you'll urinate it away. Electrolytes help your neurons maintain the right electrical conductivity. Think of it like this. Steel is a better conductor than, say, rubber, but it doesn't conduct as well as gold. Any alteration in levels can have effects on how easily currents pass across your nervous system. Having low or high electrolytes levels can result in abnormal electrical discharges, which is basically your brain sending out random signals. When this happens, the currents glitch out like the swing set from Grand Theft Auto 4. Before we move on, the data says that if I ask you to give this video a like and subscribe, you'll be 133% more likely to interact. So, go ahead and leave a comment below with what you learned from today's episode. Typically, we get plenty of electrolytes from the food we eat. We get sodium from salts, potassium from fruits like bananas, calcium from dairy or leafy greens, and so on. Unless Sam had made some drastic dietary changes, it's likely that her electrolytes deficiency was from something else. Something prevented her body from absorbing them. There are a few possible culprits behind her untimely passing. Sam's mother found hundreds of sugar-free Trident wrappers and receipts with several packets of chewing gum on them in her bedroom. In interviews following her passing, Morgan has said, "As a parent, you give your kids chewing gum and you don't think anything of it. The artificial stuff that is in chewing gum is so dangerous. Aspartame and sorbitol." However, Dr. Paul Griffiths, the coroner for this case, said that calling sweeteners the cause of death is dubious. There is very little evidence. There are only two case reports about weight loss. No one has actually died as a result of chewing gum. He also noted that the lack of magnesium, calcium, sodium, and potassium, four important electrolytes, could have been caused by the masses of chewing gum lodged in her stomach, not necessarily the sweeteners. So, was it aspartame, sorbitol, or an intestinal blockage that prevented her body from absorbing these minerals? We've talked about aspartame before, but in short, it's about 200 times sweeter than sugar and has been approved by the FDA since 1983. It is also one of the most researched chemical additives in human food supplies and has been considered safe to consume under certain concentrations. That being said, aspartame has been seen to deplete magnesium, one of the minerals that Sam lacked leading up to her passing. Although salt, sugar, caffeine, alcohol, carbs, and regular old stress can impair magnesium absorption. But what does this have to do with Sam's death? Well, not only did she have a deficiency of this mineral, but magnesium has also been connected with loss of appetite, nausea, vomiting, fatigue, and weakness, and what doctors call a marked irritability of the nervous system, which means that in severe cases, you can suffer seizures. Aspartame isn't the most prevalent sweetener in the gum that Sam was eating, though. She might have been experiencing some adverse effects, but it's likely not the answer we're looking for. On the same note, xylitol is likewise present in Trident gum at lower levels than other sweeteners. Not only that, but in one long-term study, participants ate an average of 3 pounds of xylitol per month, with a daily intake around 400 grams, and none of them experienced any major negative effects. However, it should be noted that sugar alcohols, of which aspartame and xylitol are included, can cause gastrointestinal issues when consumed in larger quantities. But how severe and the concentration is dependent on the person. So, if aspartame isn't the major sweetener for the gum Sam was eating, what was? Trident gum uses about 1.25 grams of sorbitol as a primary sweetener per stick. With around 16 to 18 sticks per pack, an entire pack of gum contains around 20 to 22 grams of sorbitol. So, if Sam was to be poisoned by artificial sweeteners, then sorbitol would have been in the highest concentration. Sorbitol is a sugar alcohol that is used mostly in the food industry as a sweetener, and to improve shelf life as a preservative. It does occur naturally in lots of fruits too, like apples, pears, and raisins among others. So, what does sorbitol do to your body? Doses of more than 20 grams of sorbitol per day can cause diarrhea. Keep in mind that that is only one pack's worth. And according to Samantha Leah, MD, there is at least one case report of weight loss associated with sorbitol consumption. Diarrhea is basically just when your intestines can't absorb all the liquids from the foods you eat. Usually 90% of all fluid entering the small intestine is absorbed by your body. But when something limits your intestine's absorption, you get diarrhea. Now, diarrhea isn't just gross, it's also dangerous. If any of you have traveled the Oregon Trail, you know just how quickly dysentery can take you. Diarrhea is dangerous not only because it can dehydrate you in a snap, it can also deplete your body of key minerals like sodium, potassium, and chloride, which also happen to be electrolytes. And if you remember, Sam had low levels of magnesium, calcium, sodium, and potassium. So, perhaps the laxative effects of sorbitol are what threw her body out of whack. It's hard to say. There aren't any reports that she was suffering from any wayward laxative effects, but that's probably for the best. There is another possible culprit here. If you remember, Dr. Griffith said that 4 or 5 bright green lumps lodged in Sam's stomach, which turned out to be balls of chewing gum. Sam's electrolyte deficiency could have been caused by a simple stomach blockage, which kept her body from absorbing the nutrients she needed. See, swallowing one piece of gum isn't so bad. It'll pass right through you like anything else, and it definitely doesn't stay in your body for 7 years. It might stay in you for like 48 hours, but whenever your body encounters something it can't break down in acid and absorb, it'll just dump it. It's the intestinal equivalent of sorting the recycle from the trash. But when you swallow a lot of gum, or just some gum with other non-digestible objects, that's when you can gum up the works. An intestinal blockage could also explain Sam's electrolyte deficiency. The symptoms do include severe abdominal pain and vomiting. And if she was eating an entire package of gum per day, it seems safe to assume that she was at risk. Sam's mother, Morgan, has lamented that they wouldn't put down that it was definitely from chewing gum, but aided from chewing gum. Doctors and scientists worth their salt will rarely use decisive language like, "this caused that," or "this proves that," because they've been trained to recognize that the world is more complicated than simple cause and effect. Our bodies are especially complicated, and we're constantly maintaining a balance that keeps us going. All it takes is too much of something to quickly throw us out of balance. This isn't a story about speculating on the death of a young girl, but understanding how important it is to learn as much as we can about what we're putting into our bodies. Chemicals aren't inherently bad or good. What can become bad is our relationships with those substances. Sugar isn't bad, but our relationship to it as a culture is making us unhealthy. In the end, chewing gum isn't bad, nor is sorbitol, or xylitol, or aspartame. What is dangerous is our relationship to these substances. Just be informed about what is going into your body, and you can avoid any sticky situations in the future.